suffering for our freedom. The Lamb of God in my place. Your blood poured out, my sin erased. It was my death you died. I am raised to life.
Real quick, before we move on into this song, this past week I was talking to Anthony, and with it being the beginning of the year and all, I kept telling myself, like, I know that I have a call from the Lord, I have a vision from the Lord, I've seen it, but I'm waiting in it. I'm waiting because I don't know where I'm going yet. And all I could think to myself was, I'm waiting, I'm waiting, I'm waiting. And after a lot of thought and a lot of prayer, I realized that the Lord's not telling me to wait, He's telling me to prepare. Okay, so when Blake scheduled me this song, I listened to it with totally different ears this time because it's called Holy Ground. And it's literally, if you listen to the words, she's saying, He's not there yet. He's not moving yet. We're preparing our hearts to be holy ground for Him to move in and work. Okay, so I was praying and trying to think of the words to say, the verse to say, and all I could come up with was, but I am deaf to all their threats. I am silent before them as one who cannot speak. I choose to hear nothing, and I make no reply, for I am waiting for you, O Lord. You must answer for me, Oh Lord, my God. So when you hear this song and you hear these words, I want you to think of whatever you have in your life that you're waiting on. I want you to sit in that and think about it. And instead of waiting on the Lord, prepare yourself for the Lord to move, because he will and he is. Amen.
By power. desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. And through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished. The end is written. Jesus Christ, my
out. have been faithful. Will you sing this to him just for a moment? All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. We just lift your hands all over the room just for one moment and begin to lift your heart to him and just talk to him and just tell him thank you that he's good to you. Thank you that in the dark times he is still light. Thank you that when you feel alone, he is really always there. You're never alone. Thank him that for every blessing that has entered into your heart and entered into your life has come from him because he loves you. None of us are too small to be seen by him. None of us are too big that he can't be there and show us who he really is. Just right now, just surrender your heart to him. His goodness chases after us. He is our living hope. He is everything to us. On the third day in the morning, he sealed the promise, and his very body began to breathe. That wasn't for him to boast about. That wasn't for him to say, I am the one who's the king around here. He did those things for you. He did those things to show you that he loves you. And Jesus is king, but he's king for you. And he'll never stop chasing you. Somebody in this room needs to hear that right now. You've been running from the Lord for a very long time. And he is your living hope. He is the one who is chasing you and will never, never stop. He loves you.
Hallelujah.
Just the voices sing this.
Praise the one.
Come on. This room, let's sing it again.
Hallelujah.
Come on, sing it with a loud voice. Sing it with your heart.
Jesus Christ, my living hope.
Come on now, praise him that he is your living hope. Come on.